Hi guys. So I did it. I bought back in at the new all-time high of $5,100. I scaled up from 25% crypto to 45% crypto. And then just to make it complete, I did another 3% to make it 50% crypto at $5,700 yesterday. So this could be the stupidest move of my life, or it could be a good move. It all depends whether crypto goes up or not. I think it's weird because most people that I admire as investors think actually it's gonna go down. Only Bitcoin will go up and also will continue to go down. And we might get a bear market where Bitcoin goes down again and alts continue to go down. So it's weird because I think that that after this Bitcoin shoot up, we will get another altcoin shoot up. I don't believe this bull will end with Bitcoin. I think it will end with altcoins. But of course, it's something to say for that not to happen because, Bitcoin had a lot to catch up, but I think it has no chance to catch it up all. It's just a bounce, I call that, from losing a lot of market cap to gaining back some. That was inevitable to happen, and the question is only how much. And while we went from 40% market dominance, it was first 80, and then it went down to 40, and now it's back up to 55. But I think 60, that's gonna be it. But I could be wrong. I'm always wrong in estimating how high something goes. So who knows? Maybe it goes to 65, 70%. But I think it's very unlikely it goes back to 80%. Very unlikely. So for me, the right move right now is to, when I buy crypto, I did buy some Bitcoin. I have some bigger Bitcoin position now, but. I'm buying alts for the most part. I really do believe in that. I think the situation with Bitcoin is just bad. Another fork, two forks now, Bitcoin Gold and Bitcoin Seg with 2x. So that's just, Bitcoin Gold is not important, but Bitcoin Seg with 2x means another piece of the Bitcoin community is split off from Bitcoin Core. And I think they will not succeed because they don't have as much fanatical support as the two other camps, the Bitcoin Core camp and the Bitcoin Cash camp have a lot of fanatics and a lot of investor support. I don't think Bitcoin Segwit2x has that. It has a lot of business support, but businesses don't invest in cryptocurrencies. They just offer services to clients. I think that's why I think it's not gonna go. The first thing you need for a coin is capital support. That's gonna bring the value, and I don't think it's there for Segwit2x. But I could be totally wrong in this. But that means that many of these people that do support Segwit2x, and those are important businesses, will have to make a choice between Bitcoin Core or Bitcoin Cash. And I think a decent part will choose for Bitcoin Cash because for them, there's a reason why they were insisting on Bitcoin Segwit2x is because just the high transaction fees of Bitcoin and long confirmation times is just not acceptable for their businesses. They know it's not gonna work out with their Bitcoin businesses. And so that's a good thing for Bitcoin Cash. At the same time, Bitcoin Cash price has really collapsed versus Bitcoin. It started at 0.1, went up to 0.3, and now it's down to 0.05. So I think it's a good buy, and I've bought some of that. But I have also bought, put some more in following the Blue Magic Capital portfolios, and doing some other Byte Ball, of course, and Black Bytes also, very lowly priced. At the same time, I protect myself also. I do hold a Bitcoin position now, probably more than 15% or so, because it is possible that Bitcoin goes up a lot versus altcoins and continues to do so as it goes up to who knows what crazy price, 8,000, 10,000. The problem is that masses are slow to react, but the only thing they will react to is Bitcoin. All the rest they don't know. So the masses are coming in and they buy Bitcoin and they don't even know that there are problems in Bitcoin or that it costs a lot to send Bitcoin. They don't know that, but they know they're finally ready after hearing many years about it to invest in Bitcoin, because all the rest they only heard about the last year but never before. So that's how it goes. Capital moves slow, and so that's why it's possible Bitcoin goes up a lot versus the altcoins, and that's certainly possible. But I think therefore Bitcoin Cash is a good investment, because this is the first thing they will go to after Bitcoin. It's Bitcoin Cash has the most has also that brand name that they know, but it has cheap transaction fees, and it's also supported by some Bitcoin fanatics. So that's why I think it's a good investment. But in the long term, I think the problem with all these Bitcoin forks is they have also no innovation. Okay, they, in my opinion, they don't do the bad stuff. Like, I don't think SegWit is a good thing at all. So that's a good thing with Bitcoin Cash, but they don't do the good stuff neither. Like, a coin needs privacy. A coin needs scalability. I think it does have Bitcoin Cash, but it does not have any privacy, for example. We'll have to see, because the proof of work system it does create centralization in the mining, and it's not. It still has no business model. Bitcoin Cash also not. How is everybody paid? It's still not solved in Bitcoin Cash, and that's what actually Bitcoin tries to solve. They all talk about it's about scalability, but I don't believe that's the case. It's about making money of it, and that's what the Bitcoin Core team tries to do with building another layer on top and scaling that. Instead of scaling Bitcoin itself, they built a new layer where they can earn fees and make money. That's the whole point, but at the same time it loses the spirit of Bitcoin by doing that. So that's the whole conflict. But Bitcoin Cash needs to solve that too, because people do need to get paid. But the way to solve that is the way Dash has done it, I think, by implementing a business model on the chain, on the primary chain. And Decred indeed has that done too, and some others too. I think that's a great idea. At the same time, I actually invest today most in Byteball, and it does not have a sustainable business model, but it does have a business model in the short term. They do have still half of the coins to distribute, and they can choose to distribute that to pay for devs and marketeers, and that's I think the smart move here, not to just give them all away for free to users. You do need to pay people to make it all happen. So that's, and you do that with new coins or coins that you create, so that all shareholders, all coin holders pay that bill. So I think that's a very good idea, and I hope that Tony from Byteball goes in that direction. What else can I say about the crypto world? Well, yeah, it's just interesting how I changed my mind and attitude totally, and how that is different from many others. So it could be that I'm really wrong here, but it's just, for me, it's the same as what happened in 2013. I was also very skeptical we would get another bubble, but once it breached the all-time high, it went from 255 to 55, and then it went to 100 for a couple of months, was there, and then it started to go up 255 again, and then I said, okay, it shoots to 255, that means we're in a new bubble, and I did buy some altcoins, and that was the right move, but way too little. At the time, I was only 20-25% exposed to crypto, and then I bumped it up to 30% crypto in that move, and then Bitcoin went from 255 to 1,150, and altcoins went not times 5, but times 40. So I feel, for me, it's a deja vu situation here. It's the same situation, and I think I'm doing better because, well, I was also at only 25 now, but instead of going to only 30, I go to 50. Because, well, you know, I think it's going to happen again. It's going to go up a lot again, and so it's important to catch that ride. That's my opinion. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and please check my Twitter if you haven't subscribed yet. It's really cool. And have a great day. Bye.